Well, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. So sorry if I have to keep the camera off, but I will show a video and the connection, I could lose the connection. So I'm Merit Quarta from the University of Parma, and today I'm glad to share the results of my PhD research project focused on inhalable microparticles embedding therapeutic calcium phosphate nanoparticles for heart targeting. And I would like to thank the committee for this opportunity. The aim of this project is to deliver the drug directly to the heart with a simple breath. So the drug carriers are biocompatible and biodegradable calcium phosphate nanoparticles loaded with a therapeutic molecule. So to avoid the risk of nanoparticle exhalation, the strategy is to embed the nanoparticles in a microparticulate powder that after the inhalation is deposited into the deep lung, in particular at the alveolar region, where the nanoparticles across the blood-air barrier following the blood flow through the pulmonary vein, they quickly reach the heart. The nanoparticles then are captured by the cardiac tissue, and the drug cargo is finally released to the cardiomyocytes with the objective to restore the normal heart activity. Compared to the traditional administration routes, this project aims to have specificity with the lower drug dose and reduce the side effects, obtaining a more efficient and more patient-friendly therapy. So to prepare the mimetic peptide nanoparticles, briefly, a calcium citrate solution was mixed with a phosphate solution in which was dissolved the mimetic peptide, and the pH was just 9. Then the mix has been placed in a water bath at 37 degrees for 5 minutes to destabilize the calcium citrate complex in order to allow the nanoparticles precipitation. Then the dispersion was dialyzed for 24 hours in order to purificate the nanoparticles. Particles from the reactive residual components. The mimetic peptide is a therapeutic substance that selectively inhibits the intracytoplasmatic degradation of the cardiac L-type calcium channel complex, improving the contractility of the cardiomyocyte and thus restoring the normal heart activity. So this peptide, as it is not able to internalize the cardiomyocyte, and the carrier is needed. The peptide-loaded nanoparticles, after the dynamic light scattering analysis, show the zeta average of 115 nanometers and a polydispersity index of 0.15, not properly monomodal dispersion, probably due to the some nanoparticles aggregates as revealed by TEM micrographs. So the nanodispersion stability was proved by the zeta potential measurements that indicate a negative surface charge of minus 25 millivolts. An HPLC analytical method was also developed to assess the peptide content that was around 7%, expressed as a percentage of the peptide amount on nanoparticles amount in the dispersion. So in agreement with the hydroxyapatite nanostructure, the calcium and the phosphate molar ratio has found to be 1.67. And the X-ray analysis allowed to measure the value of 4 for the crystallinity index that is reported as a splitting factor. To construct the microparticles to be nailed by the spray drying technique, the mannitol as adjuvant was used in a ratio 4:1 with the nanoparticles. So this ratio, fixed based on a design of experiment study, led to raw microstructure formation with a volume diameter less than 2 microns, as confirmed by the laser light diffraction analysis. Surprisingly, the mimetic peptide presents determine a peculiar internal structure of these dry microparticles, as it can be shown here in the image on the left. So never such distribution of nanometric porous was described before, and this void could increase the porosity of these particles. That is one of the main parameters determining the aerodynamic behavior. Indeed, the fine particle fraction peaked to 80%, and the extra fine particle fraction was higher than 50%. Moreover, the manufactured microparticles were able, when dissolved in water, to restore the nanoparticles in their original quality in terms of size and surface trade. The human immortalized lung cells, alveolar type 1, alveolar type 2, and alveolar macrophages were then analyzed. The cell viability by entity test and the inflammatory cytokine release by ELISA test for the interleukin 6 and 8 have been assessed. So the cells were exposed for 24 hours to the microparticles formulation at increasing concentration, and the results suggest that the microparticles formulation is not toxic for human lung alveolar epithelial cells or macrophages, and not induce the cytokine release. The mimetic peptide activity was then in vitro in murine cardiac cells, HL1 assessed the calcium intracellular uptake, performing the fluo direct calcium assay. So for this treatment, R7W mimetic peptide reported in the graphs as green dots, self-internalized the cardiomyocytes, so was used as positive control. And then different concentration of microparticles loaded with the peptide were administered in a serum-free medium that is a stressful condition for the cells. As shown in the graphs, the microparticles embedding the loaded with the peptide nanoparticles allowed the internalization in the myocyte, increasing the intracellular calcium level with a dose-dependent mechanism. So finally, the developed powder was tested in a porcine model of heart failure with the reduced ejection fraction from 60 to 20% induced via tachypathing, and the animals inhaled 12 milligrams per kilo of microparticles loaded with 60 micrograms per kilo of mimetic peptide through a customized mask for 14 days of treatment. The unloaded microparticles and mimetic peptide free were used as control. So the effect of the treatment was monitored by a telemetry system, and the preliminary data suggests, as shown by echocardiography of these mini pigs, that the microparticles improves the cardiac contractility, increasing the ejection fraction to 60%. So the treatment was well tolerated and no adverse event occurred. However, the pharmacokinetic and the pharmacodynamic studies are still ongoing. So I would like to thank my professor and all Cupido partners for the great effort involved in this project. And if you would know more details about the dry powder inhaler developed during this project, you can follow the on-demand presentation held by Nemera. So thank you for joining, and I'm looking forward to answer your questions.
Thank you, Erin. That was quite interesting, and good to see a slightly different target heading towards the heart rather than the lung. So one of the questions came through as related to that. How do we make sure that the peptides only go at the heart and don't get dispersed elsewhere?
Yes, so the pharmacokinetic and the pharmacodynamic studies are still ongoing. However, this mimetic peptide selectively inhibits the intracytoplasmatic degradation of the L-type cardiac calcium channel.
Okay. And,
thank you for your question.
And is it possible the nanoparticles would pick up proteins from the serum and that would change their action?
So, however, based on the literature studies, has been already demonstrated when the calcium phosphate nanoparticles were loaded with the microRNA, so that is a different molecule from the mimetic peptide. So they reach directly the heart if they are administered by inhalation. However, in these studies, the nanoparticles were administered as liquid dispersion and not as dry powder. And so the aim of this project is to develop a dry powder inhaler so that is more stable compared to the liquid dispersion of these nanoparticles. As I saw in the slide, so the extra fine particle fraction was higher than 50%. And also, as demonstrated by the preliminary in vivo study, they seem to reach directly the target that is firstly the lung, but then the target is the final target is the heart.
That's brilliant, thank you. And you'll also see in the comments, it's not so much a question, but just a comment about how innovative that is, and it's brilliant work. So we look forward to seeing data in humans in due course. Thank you for sharing with us today. That's been brilliant.
Thank you so much.